Okay, so just like Kelly mentioned, we have released recently the Walmart repricing. So let me go through a few basic things about the repricing and how it works, and then also I will go more deep into how we created this repricing and how it works, how it can help you to sell on Walmart. So first of all, I would like to cover a topic of buy box. So on this, the buy box really was initiated by Amazon. As you know, on Amazon, there could be many sellers selling one particular product, but there could be only one default seller. So when you click Add to Cart, which is located on the product page, then automatically this product is sold by a buy box winner, a seller which is assigned to this buy box as the best seller according to Amazon. Now, buyers can pick another seller by just clicking on other sellers list on the product page and just picking another seller, but yes, as everybody knows, this is more work for buyers, and most of the buyers, they do not bother really to shop more for which seller to buy it from. Usually they just go with the default option. On Amazon, it's a little bit complicated how the entire algorithm, how Amazon is picking those sellers for the buy box. It's from among many different indicators. There are things like the price, your ranking, how many products you're selling. So the entire algorithm that they have to pick a buy box winner is pretty complicated. On Amazon, I mean, on Walmart and on Jet is much simpler. So let me now go to Jet. So on Jet, if you're selling on Jet, you know by now probably that there's no really indication on the product page who's the a seller. Jet works as a dropshipper, so they really take your products and they reformat the way they want a product page to look like, and they just sell it to people. So from the customer standpoint, when they shop on Jet, they are really shopping from Jet, and all those calculations, who's going to ship a product, is happening on the back end. So Jet algorithm is determining this, who's gonna ship the product. And in Jet case, the biggest factor, the most important factor is price. So on Walmart, Walmart is closer to Amazon in this regard. So they do have a buy box, and they have also a list of other sellers. So this is the similarity between Amazon and Walmart. So the Walmart buy box algorithm is much more simpler than Amazon. Over here on Walmart, the most important factor is really the price, and they do not take anything else under consideration really. So yeah, we try to I mean, whatever they told us, that's currently the price is the only really factor that determines who's the winner of the buy box. So one thing that you have to know is that if you are competing with Walmart for the buy box and you have the same price, then you will lose. So they always make their offer to be above yours. But if you offer even a little bit cheaper product, they claim that they always will let this better price to win. So technically you can without issues, you should without issues compete with Walmart. So we have new pages in our panel. So one is insights. So this page displays information provided by Walmart API about the buy box. So on this screen, you can see here that, so we have information about products on the left-hand side. Then you have your current price. And then on the right-hand side, you can see what Walmart sees for this product on their end. So in this particular example, actually, you can see that the product number on top, it shows that your price on Walmart is $7.49. Okay, is there a template to upload all repricing and promotions or each product? So you can, if you go to the repricing page in the top right corner, file with your products, and it's okay, so this is a little bit off-topic question, but yeah, I'm happy to answer this question. So this is the question about the SKU override, and the, I guess this is this another override. So yeah, so there are those two options that Walmart allows sellers to, those advanced options to do the promo, the code override, the UPC override, and the SKU override. So yeah, so sometimes when you have, when your product is listed incorrectly, on Walmart, then, you need to, make sure that your UPC is correct. And then you have to use one of those overrides. Actually, that's a pretty good question, because also you can use this insight, section to find if your product is correctly or incorrectly linked with another product within Walmart catalog. Very often, if you go to those insight sections, you may see that your product is, let's say, like few hundred dollars more expensive or cheaper than competitors. So this is really a red flag that you should investigate to see if your product is really linked to a correct product on the Walmart marketplace. And so yeah, so in very often you have to just, I mean, in this case you have to actually contact Walmart and let them know about this issue. Very often they have a wrong somebody else has provided wrong UPC code, and then even if you have a provided correct UPC code, then you are just affected because you are connected to a wrong product. So there are those two overrides. So one override is the SKU override. So SKU override means you have, let me see, maybe I can show you this, what I'm here talking about. Let me log into our test account. So let's see, if I'm editing one of the products, here under additional attributes, we are allowing you to specify the SKU override and product ID override. So how it works is, this is used to force updates in a Walmart database. Usually you should use those two parameters only when Walmart is really asking you to do so. Very often when you have this wrong UPC provided, because you are just like incorrectly linked to a product within Walmart database, then they have to clean up the database, they have to refresh their cache, and then they tell you just resubmit your product with SKU override ID, the SKU override attribute to be set up as true. So difference between those two is that SKU override happens when you have correct UPC code, but you want to change your SKU on this UPC code. So that usually happens when, you just, for example, you're just selling this product also somewhere else, and you want to be consistent that you have the same SKU across all the marketplaces, but for some reason you submitted this particular product to Walmart with you with wrong SKU. So you have to. Since products are identified within Walmart based on SKU, then you have to use this parameter to override this SKU. So if you just insert here SKU override, and here you put true, and then you click save and export to Walmart, that will it will send an information to Walmart. This particular SKU of mine should be associated with this UPC. If there is any other product on my account with this particular Yeah, for the shipping, it's, I mean, the Walmart is expecting for the last few months, actually it started during the holidays, they started expecting sellers to actually provide the free shipping. So as a default, actually, they expect that you provide free shipping to your products, and then you have to just do those overrides to really set up the shipping. But yeah, I mean, I know that they also made recently some changes to their shipping settings. They had some issues also with this, with the updating this information. So it's hard for me to tell you more about this. So it's really, we're still also learning about this. And probably that's the best question just for Walmart support. Okay, so there is a question if that about the Jet and Walmart integration. So we do not have. So we contacted Walmart and Jet representatives, and they declined that there is nothing that they know about. If there is any merge of those two companies in terms of the technology, so we will know about this if that will happen, because it will probably, I mean, it will very much affect the way that we process all of those repricings and orders. But from what I see, those two platforms are very different. Both of them, they have different approach to the API. So definitely Walmart was using a little bit, I mean, now they are switching to more modern technology, but they were using an old style of API, handling API. Jet was much more modern. So we see now that Walmart is improving this, and they are trying to catch up with how Jet is handling this. But from what we see, those two databases that they have, they are not too much compatible, especially those variations. So if you are working with setting up the variations and grouping of products, you may notice that definitely the, I mean, it's so many differences between those Jet and Walmart platform. Also, Jet is less strict with the ID of your products. So for example, they are very fine with you having only ASIN from Amazon, but on the other hand, Walmart is very strict. They just want to see their UPC or AIN, EIN. So it will be very difficult for them to actually easily merge those two platforms. And I don't know if it's probably not only about the technology question, but also about the, from the business standpoint, I'm not sure if merging those two platforms would be, for them, like, good from the business standpoint. So currently there are definitely two separate teams which approve applications. So we have many sellers who are approved on Jet, but they have a hard time to be approved on Walmart, and also all their way around. So definitely those are two separate marketplaces. And it will take time, definitely. In case they want to merge them to some extent, then definitely that will take them time to make this happen. Okay, so it's already 1 hour. And definitely if you have some more questions, you can send it to us. You can either reply to our email, which we send out with an announcement of the reply of the webinar, or just send us an email to support@geekseller.com. You can indicate in your subject line that this is for Daniel, or that this is about the repricing. So then I will make sure that my team will forward me this email, and I will look into this. And yes, I said that this repricing functionality is very young. We still also explore the possibilities of this repricing tool. So if you have some ideas or you see some issues, then definitely send it to us, and we will review it, and hopefully we'll also just start to, just will improve the tool